Welcome to this video on troubleshooting web parts in SharePoint 2013. If you have corrupted or problematic web parts, you can troubleshoot using the Web Part Maintenance page. It lets you work with multiple web parts at a time, so it's more efficient than working with each web part individually. Click the Page tab and edit Properties. Confirm the checkout, scroll to the bottom of the Properties page, and click Open Web Part page in Maintenance View. When you open the Maintenance View, you are editing the Public View, which is seen by all users. Switch to Personal View if you wish to edit your personal page view. We'll stick with the Public View. We don't have a problem web part at this time, so let's just review the troubleshooting options. You can work on several web parts at the same time by clicking the checkboxes next to their titles, or click Select All if you want to work on all web parts at the same time. Options include closing, resetting, or deleting web parts. By now you're familiar with closing and deleting web parts. In this example, you can see that the team discussion has been closed. The reset option restores the settings to the values for the public view. This overrides any personalized settings that any user has created. What's the best troubleshooting technique? If you are not sure which web part is causing problems, close one web part and go back to Web Part page to see if that fixes the issue. If the problem persists, repeat this for each web part. When the problem disappears, you found the suspect web part. In this video, we've examined how to troubleshoot web parts. We encourage you to check out our other SharePoint videos, as well as the reference and training materials on the SharePoint Help site. On Connect NCDOT, there is a link to help on every page. Go to the main Help page and click SharePoint Help to see the SharePoint Help information. On Inside NCDOT, there is a link to the Help site in the header and footer of every page. Those links also take you to the SharePoint Help site. For information on upcoming SharePoint classes, log into Beacon and check the LMS training calendar, or contact the PC training group. Thanks for watching.